Hey guys, and welcome back to the MedBros channel. And in today's video, we're going to be comparing medical school to residency. Again, a lot of you guys just got into residency. Congratulations on matching. So we're going to compare what exactly you were in with what exactly you are about to get yourselves into. So the number one thing we're going to be comparing is going to be the stress that you face in medical school versus residency. Which one is more stressful? Well, in medical school, you have this impending doom on your head at all times of step one. And then you have these tests coming up and all this stuff. Every couple weeks, you have a really hard test that you study weeks of material, which you would take in college, would take weeks on weeks to study. You need to cram it into 2 weeks and then regurgitate on a test and then do it again nonstop until you get hit with the giant step one test. That's traditionally how it was, and that's traditionally what made medical school stressful. As you know, with all the recent changes, a lot of this is changing. Step one is now pass, no pass. We'll see what that does in the long run, but for hypothetically, if you don't have this giant exam that your entire future depends upon, should be a lot less stressful. A lot of schools also stick to the pass, no pass system for their regular tests that you have on a daily basis. So all you really have to do is pass that test. Now you do have the stress of getting into a residency program still kind of looming over you during medical school. And anytime you're in a position where you're applying for something, you could potentially get rejected. It's a stressful situation. So that is pretty much most of the stressors that you face in medical school. There's additionally also things of, your peers and imposter syndrome and, very difficult tests and other people succeeding or not, and add on to the kind of social aspects and all the other things, you know, relationships with attendings, having certain professors, adding all of these things on are definitely stressful, especially when you get to your clerkship years where you have to go to the hospital and you're dealing with different personalities. That certainly is there for medical students, so we'll keep that in mind. But how does all this compare to residency? Residency is a whole different set of stresses. Most of residency stress comes from dealing with other people's personalities, dealing with time frames that you're given, getting in early enough, rounding on your patients, having the right information, trying not to get embarrassed on a daily basis by your attending physician, basically dealing with other people. Stress levels can be significantly reduced in certain rotations where you're just vibing with an attending. You can have a really great time in residency. Stress comes from when you're dealing with individuals that might not be as compatible with you as you think. There are still exams. You have to take step three, which again, is not that high profile compared to the other exams. You really just have to pass it to make sure you get your license. Many programs, including my own, do a kind of yearly test to make sure you're up to standards. And if you fail it, that's a whole nother stressor that you have to kind of study and take it again. But for the most part, most people get through it just fine. There's the stresses of dealing with your patients dying, with the emotional aspect of all of it, with especially now in this year with a pandemic, dealing with parents, dealing with family members. All of these are really the stressors in residency. So make sure with all of these, you let me know in the comments below which one you find more stressful. But for me, I would definitely say residency is a little more stressful than medical school. Especially if I had these changes that they're making now in medical school, I would definitely be having a good time in medical school compared to what I went through. Residency just brings up a whole host of other problems and more difficult to deal with problems than just your own personal stresses because you're dealing with other people. Overall, it just comes together as being a more stressful experience. Now, why don't we talk about the difficulty? What is actually harder to do? What content, what learning, what is just overall the more difficult experience, medical school or residency? Well, in medical school, you're learning a lot of the technical details of being a doctor. You're learning the ins and outs of cells and pathology and treatments and things like that. So if learning from a book and doing these tests and regurgitating all this information is not your strong suit, you might think that medical school is a lot harder than the residency portion. Residency consists of doing your learning, but more in a practical basis. If a case comes up and you don't know what to do about that condition, you read up on it, you read up on the medications, you're learning as you go, you're learning what's really practical and you're applying it right there on the spot. So in terms of which one is more difficult, it really depends on what you think yourself and what your strengths are. So if you're more of a person that doesn't like tests and doesn't like reading all the time and doesn't really like getting into the technical details, you're gonna have a hard time in medical school. For me, I really enjoyed medical school. I love getting in the nitty gritty of physiology and pathology and things like that. And I had a great time. Residency, on the other hand, is doing all of your work, getting notes in, seeing patients, doing all this stuff, learning on the side, not really learning as efficiently as I would like, trying to keep up with it all. That can be kind of annoying. But in all honesty, residency, once you get a hang of it, now that I'm finally getting towards the end of my first year, it really is a procedural kind of thing. You go in, you see your patients, you follow through with all the kind of exams and things like that. You put together your differential, you put together your treatment, and then you always have somebody above you that's going to help you out. Even when you become a senior, even when you become an attending eventually, you have other attendings to rely on if you need help with something. So there is always a support system for you. And I just feel like once you get a hang of it, residency is what it is. Taking care of patients is what it is. And the difficulty in comparison, I might give this one to medical school. But again, this goes hand in hand with medical school becoming pass or no pass. Exams like step one not even being a factor. It really is going to be debatable on which one is going to be more difficult. For me, why I still go to medical school is even with these changes, to have to go out and create these letters and do all this research and getting into residency for me personally seems a little more annoying than it would have been back in the day, where test scores and things like that play a little more of a role. So you don't have to do some of this extra stuff that's at times some of this stuff you don't feel like doing. So I'm still going to give it to medical school. And now let's talk about this one. This one has a clear cut winner. It is the hours you put in. And in medical school, the hours you physically put in, depending on your program, if you have mandatory class or not, isn't really that much. If you choose not to go to class, you learn on your own time, you kind of wake up at your own time, you enjoy your day while you sprinkle in some studying, you know, sprinkle in, I mean, 6 to 8 hours sprinkling in there. Nevertheless, you're studying away on your own pace. You can go to Starbucks, get a nice coffee, sit there and learn. That sounds a lot more enjoyable rather than residency, where you have to show up on a schedule every day. You have a boss, you have to report to them, things have to be done the way they like it. It can get very annoying. For me, medical school easily takes that one. And then I want to talk about comparing the environment that you're in, medical school versus residency. Medical school, I don't know how it is now that you're on Zoom and you're not really interacting with your classmates, but there's definitely more of a connection. You're seeing people, you're coming together for labs, mandatory work, you know individuals, you're hanging out. It's a great time in medical school in terms of that. There is the competitive aspect, not at all so much in my program that I've experienced, but you definitely hear stories of people having a more competitive atmosphere and individuals vying for top one spots and AOA spots and all this stuff. And it can be very, very stressful in that manner in some other programs. Luckily, the program I went to was amazing. Didn't have to deal with that, but that's something definitely to take into consideration. Residency, on the other hand, is a good and bad thing in another way. So there's definitely a camaraderie among your residents. You guys are all in the same boat. Nobody's really competing for anything at this point. Everyone's really on the same page with what they want to do. Everyone wants to get their work done. Everyone wants to give the best patient care. Everyone wants to just get home to their families. Overall, everyone's on the same page. The difficulty comes in with dealing with personalities that you don't vibe with. If there are residents you don't vibe with, if there are attendings you don't vibe with, that you're stuck with, that you cannot change. It's a very smaller atmosphere. You interact with the same people in your program for the 3 years that you're there. And it can be quite difficult dealing with all the kind of different personalities. I haven't had any issues myself, aside from a couple particular attendings, but for the most part, it's been great. I can see how this is far less ideal than the medical school environment. Again, I didn't have this competitive environment that people complained about usually. So for me, great experience, no issues, no complaints. So medical school will take it for me, but I'm sure a lot of you out there might say residency. Overall, which one do I like better? Did I like my medical school experience or did I like my residency experience? While I loved medical school, I really had a great time. I was fortunate enough not to have these 15-hour sessions aside from studying for step one. It was a reasonable amount of studying every day. I did really well. I got along with my classmates, didn't have a competitive environment, and just had a really great time, a really good, successful medical school run, and just had a lot of time on my own to play basketball, work out, and have a great time. Despite all that, the fact that there was a lot of mandatory stuff, there was a step one looming over my head, there was tests to study for every single week. Overall, residency, on the other hand, has been nice in the sense that I have my own house now. I'm not stuck in this kind of college dorm-like environment. And we're finally doing what we love. We are out there in the hospitals. We're doing physical exams on real patients. We're interacting with real patients. We're actually doctors now. So that is a huge plus on the resident side. Despite having to get up at 5 a.m., putting in these long days, terrible hours, terrible pay, and the whole situation, overall, a lot of negatives, I still would still take residency, given that you were on our own agency for the most part, running around the hospital, doing what we love, and it's less of a confined in a little room studying medical school atmosphere like it was back in the day. Again, this might be different for a lot of you out there, but for me, I will still give it to residency. out there doing what we love, and I'm having a good time. Let me know if you're a resident out there, you're a medical student going into residency. How do you feel about all this? What have you heard? What do you experience? I would love to hear about it in the comments down below. Make sure you guys like this video, hit subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next one.